What's going on, everybody? Nick from 618 Fishing here, and today I'm heading back to this really sweet fishing location that I discovered on one of my recent fishing outings. I don't know if you guys remember what happened last time I went out there, but I actually had to cut, the adventure short because I got interrupted by thunderstorms. Well, the sky is actually looking pretty dark today. Hopefully, it does not rain on me again. I don't want to jinx myself, but I have a pretty good feeling that the rain is going to stay away. I've made it to the rock road that leads to this location. I have about a half mile walk ahead of me, and then I could finally start fishing. I made the half mile walk, slid myself down the steep little incline to finally get to the fishing spot. I've only been here twice, but this is one of my favorite fishing locations that I've ever discovered, so I'm excited to get started. This right here, guys, is gonna be the difference maker that sets today apart from last time I was out here. This is my little micro fishing little setup. I've got my little tiny little bobbers. The hooks I'm using are size 24 J hooks. These are actually used for fly fishing to make flies. I use them for micro fishing and they do an incredible job. As far as bait goes, I'm actually gonna look under some of these rocks to find some worms. I have still yet to find any worms. I did have a backup plan. I'm not gonna give up on the worms yet, but if I can't find any, I do have a plan B. I was able to find some bait. Not sure what they are. Look like centipedes or something. I'm terrified of centipedes, but I'm gonna use them for bait and hopefully catch some fish. Oh, I think one has the bait. They're trying to, they're just nibbling at it. Oh, there's a fish. This looks like a tiny, tiny green sunfish. Holy cow. See you later, buddy. That was one of the coolest green sunfish I've ever caught. I think I might actually try out something different. As soon as I toss it in, the fish absolutely attack the bobber, but they don't pay much attention to my actual bait. So I think I'm gonna try plan B. I've got plan B all rigged up and ready to go. I actually brought my flies for fly fishing. Ooh, there's a fish. Yes, looks like another green sunfish. This one is quite a bit bigger. See you later, buddy. I really have no casting distance since it's so light, but the fish prefer this thing a lot more. See you later, buddy. Oh, fish on. Another green sunfish. See you later, buddy. Ooh, fish on. Another creek chub. See you later, buddy. See you later, buddy. I'll tell you what, guys, it never ceases to amaze me where you can find fish if you look. And this little spot right here is quite the hidden gem. There is just an entire world underneath this little puddle right here.
Oh, there we go.
Yes, another creek chub. This might be the biggest one I've caught so far, ever. It's honestly almost too easy using these little flies. Fish on, fish on. This looks like the coolest green sunfish of the day. See you later, buddy. Well guys, unfortunately I'm out of time and I'm getting destroyed by mosquitoes, so I'm gonna head out of here, but I had a lot of fun today. I caught a ton of fish compared to the last time I was out here. I started off with the microscopic hooks. I think I was able to catch one fish using those, so I switched over to the flies, and boy am I glad I did that because I caught a ton using that fly. There's actually a tiny creek that goes through the woods back here, so if you guys are interested in seeing that, comment below. But I had a lot of fun today. I hope you guys have enjoyed watching. I will catch you on the next one. The sky is actually looking pretty dark today. Hopefully it does not rain on me again. I don't want to jinx myself, but I have a pretty good feeling that the rain is going to stay away. I did jinx myself and it's actually started to rain.